This really is the first time I've seen all this.
With his masterful creations, Jim Henson touched the hearts of millions.
This is fantastic.
Now, his family of unforgettable characters are getting a new home.
It's gorgeous.
Inside Atlanta's Center for Puppetry Arts, his daughter Cheryl gave CNN the first look at what is now the largest collection of Jim Henson artifacts in the world.
Well, the whole building is new.
It's brand new,
it's spectacular.
Right? Yeah.
What I love about this building is that it feels like you're in a television studio.
It took nearly 8 years and more than $14 million.
Talk to us about some of the things that we're seeing here.
Oh my God, I love these. So this is Muppet Treasure Island.
With the heart and enthusiasm of one of her father's famous Muppets, Cheryl Henson showed us some of her favorites.
Oh, we have to talk about the seven deadly sins.
Let's talk about
okay.
it.
With every turn, precious reminders of her father, from the unmistakable to the overlooked. And yes, of course, the classics.
Whether the pig was going to be successful, I didn't know, but she did, and she obviously has done very well.
On this day, we meet Bonnie Erickson, the designer of the original Miss Piggy, who reveals some behind-the-scenes secrets, perhaps enough to make Miss Piggy clutch her pearls.
They were originally to hide the seam between her neck and her head. She had to lose that high neckline, and we had to hide it somehow, so that's how the pearls came to be.
It's been a really wonderful process to kind of go from seeing these things in a warehouse in New York to getting them here and bring them back to life to share with everyone.
And what a process it's been. The center's exhibitions director, Kelsey Fritz, says it took 3 years of restoring, restuffing, and preserving.
Puppets like Rolf here, his innards were filled with foam. So foam deteriorates over time, so you have to, we've used archival materials to conserve him and kind of get him back.
The depth of the collection showcases Henson's stunning legacy after four decades in television and film.
We want to remember my dad. We want to remember his Kermit. We want to remember how his characters cared about each other. They really take care of each other. My next dream is that people actually show up, you know? Build it and they will come. We hope they actually do come.
If only to feel like a kid again. Nick Valencia, CNN, Atlanta.